Frost ratings for most commercial cereal varieties will be available for the 2015 season. By the end of summer, the Australian National Frost Program will have accumulated 3 years of research data, allowing it to publish susceptibility rankings for 72 lines of wheat and 48 barley varieties.
We expect to have the results available to advisors and growers in sort of February, March next year. So that will give the opportunity for that information to influence variety decisions for next season.
Those frost susceptibility rankings will be incorporated into the national variety trial data. While the Frost Program has trial sites in northern New South Wales, West Australia and South Australia, the focus here at Loxton in South Australia's Mallee Country has been on rating frost sensitivity in wheat and barley crops.
So in the lead up to this program, we're involved in field testing frost reactions in barley in particular at a range of locations across the southern region, and finally settled on the Loxton location as somewhere reliable and able to give meaningful sort of frost events.
Events that led to the most common form of frost damage inflicted on cereal crops.
Yeah, so in these trials we're really looking at reproductive frost tolerance. So that's looking at the floral organs within the head that get damaged, and when they get damaged you don't have a seed being formed and you end up with a sterile floret, and that's what we refer to as frost-induced sterility.
Frost, as grain growers know, is dangerously unpredictable in terms of when it will hit and its severity. So how do you compare 72 wheat varieties and another 48 of barley, sown at various times and all hit by the same frost event?
In order to make sure we're comparing varieties at identical stages of development, and so we're not confounded by differences in their growth rates or development rates, we use, in this case at this site, we have 10 times of seeding of both wheat and barley to ensure that whenever a frost event does occur, we have the majority of those varieties at the same developmental stage to allow us to directly compare their performance.
While frosts were expected, what wasn't was a 1 in 20 year event that resulted in stem damage, something that will be included in future screening of varieties. There was also widespread damage to flowering heads.
So this is common sort of damage that we're seeing here in Loxton. The tiller looks reasonably fine, it's still green, it's still been growing, but from the frost 5 weeks ago it's actually done severe damage on the reproductive organs and has not allowed any grain growth to occur. Tears apart every floret. You can see that the anther, the male, the pollen part of the plant is still there, but it's blowing away in the wind because it's completely dead, and you can't even see the female part of the plant anymore, the ovule. It's down there somewhere, but it's just been completely burnt away by the frost.
All 120 varieties were assessed and coloured tags applied to damaged plants to identify and match their growth stage. This has been repeated after every frost event throughout the trial period.
So last year the team got through more than 1 million individual florets that were scored for sterility for the purposes of developing these wheat and barley variety ratings.
A spin-off from this research will look at a cereal's ability to compensate for frost damage.
Yes, I guess the question we're trying to answer there is, if you have 50% frost damage within a crop, does that correspond to a 50% yield loss? Or are some varieties able to better compensate by better filling secondary tillers or increasing grain size and weight in the damaged heads? So that's really something we're trying to figure out within this new project over the next few years.
The research undertaken by the University of Adelaide, DAFWA and other agencies and grower groups involved in the Australian National Frost Program is just one of many projects that make up GRDC's National Frost Initiative. And the Frost Susceptibility Ratings, one of many outcomes to help growers minimise frost risk.
So we'd expect that following the successful implementation of frost ratings for varieties, that should really become a standard part of the assessment of new varieties as they roll out. So There's an ongoing commitment to continue this testing for new wheat and barley varieties, allowing growers to expect new varieties onto the market that have that information, along with their normal yield, disease, quality related characterisations that all go into their final variety choice.
In the meantime, as of the 2015 season, growers in frost-prone areas will be able to compare their current cereal variety mix with the frost susceptibility ratings, and then decide if they're using the most suitable varieties currently available to minimise losses due to frost damage. For information on other frost research projects, see Groundcover's Frost Supplement.